have had a significant amount of public comment. I'll open the floor for public comment. 3 minutes, please, tonight. 3 minutes. Who's available for public comment? Jerry.
I know this is just.
Please step to the microphone.
Hey, just real simple. I know this is just a few minutes ago that you made the motion or whatever that you're gonna have the FMS commission meeting as part of the FMS record. Maybe you ought to do that again as part of the commission record to make it legal.
Thank you. Next speaker.
I don't think I was first on the list, but I'll go first. Anything I say tonight does not apply to those that are voting against the budget. For those that are voting for the budget, please be all ears. Mr. Mayor, where do you stand on the budget? Do you recommend its passage as it's been presented, a 48-cent increase?
Mr. Slusher, I'm gonna execute the will of the people as voted by these people. If there's 8, 10, 12, or 14 people here and the vote splits, I'll commit my vote.
How will you vote?
We'll just see if we get that. I think there are multiple ways to run government. I'd like to run it on zero. You gotta have some. I think 248 is a significant number. I think there are several ways short of that to run government.
How many commissioners gonna vote for it? Not the one. How many are gonna vote against it? It's estimated, an economic factor generally and accepted, that for $1 in taxes, you remove $3 from the economy. That's employed by the federal government. It applies to state government. It applies to local government. Pull money out, it multiplies, and it's estimated to be $3. Pull $1 million away from these poor people, you pull $3 million out of the county government. Our annual income in this county is $13,000 per capita, one of the lowest in the nation. Thank God for Mississippi. We've got fund balance. Let me tell you how rich this county is. In the general fund, we ended the year with $2,176,000 in a savings account. In the solid waste account, $771,000. In the ambulance account, this is some money in the bank, $604,000. In the industrial development fund, $232,000. In the special projects fund, $1,182,000. In the drug control fund, $30,000. In the highway fund, $865,000. In the general debt service fund, $1,581,000. We're not broke. $117,000 in the general capital outlay fund, and in the special projects fund, $437. $8 million. Just about the same place we started last year. It ain't gone down any, and they tapped it for $1.5 million. In other words, it's baloney. I've used fund balances all my life in my position, and I tap that fund balance every year, and it always came back.
Why?
I did conservative estimating. And Mr. Marlowe has been conservative, and you can bet that $8 million is going to be even higher. There's $6.5 million in the school fund. And why is that there? We've got good management. That man sitting right there is on the school board. He's the chairman. He knows where every penny is, don't you, Mike? Yes, they didn't get any money this year. They eked out pay raise for their lower paid employees through good fiscal management, the school board. Demand the same thing out of the county. One thing I want to mention, and I kind of forgot it.
Yeah.
I have bought my last copy of the Snooze Press. A bunch of clowns. Where is the man from the news press? Do you take credit for this? It's stand up, be shown. I hope no one ever buys another copy of this LaFollette Prayer. This is what they think of you, a bunch of clowns. I'm gonna pass it around, let you see it.
20 seconds, Mr. Slusher.
You got 3 minutes. We are fastly becoming a retirement community. High property taxes will ruin this. People come to this community now not because of industry. It's gone. We lost things. It's still unemployed. They come to this community now to retire. They look at one thing. What's the property taxes? What are they going to do? You going to run them out? That's your number one industry now.
That's true.
We don't need to be spending any more $16 million plus dollars on heartbreak hotels like back here, like this detention center. It's a heartbreak hotel. Go look at
it. Mr. Slush, your time's up.
By the way, the wheel tax takes a supermajority. Vote it down. I have a friend of this.
Mr. Slush,
this tax is going to fail.
Next speaker, please.
It will fail.
Do we not live in a country that has freedom of speech?
Yes, sir.
This man was making a good point. But no, you cut him out.
He's got 3 minutes just like you do. We stay here until 10 o'clock at night, and we'll stay here tonight.
My question is, why don't you let these people sitting out here that pays those taxes to pay your wages and every one of these people's wages, why don't you put it on a ballot to let them vote whether they want to pay more taxes or not?
Rick,
yeah.
You want me to answer that?
Yeah.
We have it in the springtime for the sales tax. That's the only one that we can do that way. If you do away with your whole commission, you got to go through state legislature to do it. So that's the system that we've got.
My next question is why do you put it on the property owners to bear the burden instead of putting it on everybody that buys groceries, gas, dry goods? Raise them taxes.
That's what we'll be on
property
about.
Property taxes is the most unfair tax in this world. Why? Because we work our lives away to own our own homes. But we can't do that. Because when we get it paid for, we're old and gray then. But if we don't pay our property taxes that pays every one of yours' wages, they're going to come out there and throw us off of our property and sell it out in under us. So we don't own it. The county does. We have to pay rent on it. Now, if judges would look at raising taxes where everybody has to pay, whether a citizen of this county or just somebody coming to visit, I'd be all for that. But don't put it on the property taxes because we're taxed to death now. I know I own my own business, and I pay a property tax plus a personal property tax on my stuff. I'm one of the fortunate ones. I get to work in this county. 99% of the people in this courtroom and in this county has to drive to another county to get a job because we don't have any.
Yes.
Okay. We elected you, and I've been friends with you all of my life. We elected you because we thought you would bring us some jobs in this county. But no, now you all are wanting to spend a buttload of money to go up there and build office buildings and all, and hire a man to come in there to recruit jobs. Spend more of our tax dollars so you can raise our taxes again. We've had enough. We don't want a tax increase, not on property taxes. Because you're asking a few people that owns property in this county to pay the way instead of making it toward anybody that comes to this county and buys gas and groceries and dry goods and all of that to bear the load.
I think we've got that in the works. The reason I'm pushing 3 minutes tonight, Rick, is I believe we got business to do, and I think there will be more business to do to get that tax rate tonight. Most of the people in this room have been here for multiple meetings, and we've gone till 10 o'clock at night, and I'll stay here until everybody wants to speak. But I expect tonight that we'll have multiple speakers before we can get to a vote on the tax rate. I've been on top of the barn with you with our backs to the tin. I know how you've raised, I've raised the same way. I want good things for people of this county, and I think we've got an opportunity to do it. I do.
It's not for raising taxes. It's to get taxes here where people can work.
That makes it hard.
Now, don't ask us to pay more taxes, because if you voted in, I'm going to try my best to get everybody. I'll take an ad out in the paper, I'll get on the radio, and I'm going to ask everybody that pays land taxes to stand with me to stop paying.
Yes.
Not pay another dollar of them. And without those taxes that we pay, and I'm not just talking about land taxes, I'm talking about taxes on anything. If we have to die in Kentucky to buy a grocery, go up there and buy it. Just don't pay no more taxes to where we don't have to pay wages for people that's voting to make us pay more taxes.
I understand. I think there are probably more people in this room that see it the way you see it. And if you'll yield the mic, I'll let them speak.
Yeah. I've said my piece.
Thank you. Next speaker.
Raised in Knoxville, and learned to ski, learned to swim, everything on Norris Lake. Always had a dream. Come back, buy me a little piece of land. God willing, grow up, retire, have me a little spot of earth, which is a little spot of heaven, as far as I'm concerned. I came back from Vietnam in '72, and I started saving a little bit of. Well, I didn't do what everybody else did. I was blessed. But I started saving money to buy me a little spot. Then I met my wife and we started saving money. We weren't making much. We bought a little place and we got it paid for because we couldn't stretch out and borrow. So, and then we eventually built this place. And It's been a dream. We've got a little farm up here too that we don't work, but it's been our dream. And I know that you've got to pay for your dream. Everybody knows it. But for some reason, you know, when, my memory's getting about as bad as my age. The little road that went down Swinhacket, one of the very beginning developments out in Big Creek, and he just did what they, I think the term is called a tar chip. It's just gravel and some tar on it. Well, it got so bad that when I'd be coming up here to work, I had a four-wheel drive. My wife had a little car. She couldn't get down the hill. I met with Dennis Potter several times, and he told me point blank that road improvements was not part of, did not come out of property taxes. And all of a sudden, our property taxes out there, which again, I'm just thankful to have what I've got, over doubled. It went from $1,700. Well, I was happy to have it, but all of a sudden, I'm strangling from $1,700. And yet, our roads are still washed out up there. We don't have any roads. I know that they're trying to do something, but it's not there. Again, I'm not saying that everybody doesn't need to pay a portion or something, but property taxes aren't going to improve all the roads. It's not. Everybody's got to give a little. And the other thing is, I didn't receive a letter. I'm still in Knoxville because of some health reasons in my family. I haven't gotten to move up here yet. But I never received anything in the mail about this. I didn't even know what was happening. I get back to, because my wife's not feeling real good, I get back to Knoxville to check on her, and all of a sudden it's on the news, and I turn around and give one of the ladies a call and tackle her husband and talk to him, and so turn back around and hit the road. Anyway, I'm just saying it's not the total answer to, it's my opinion. Thank you.
Thank you. Next speaker, please.
Mr. Mayor, my name is James Kingston. I know the county probably needs money. I understand that. But I really feel like we're being taken advantage of. And I feel like there's got to be other options to collect tax money. I don't think it's right. And what I would like to do, no disrespect from this panel or you, but I would like for everyone in this room to look around and take note of who votes for that tax increase. And I really think this will be the last term that you would have. I really do. I think you, every one of you will be put out. So, I mean, that's all I gotta say. I just don't appreciate what you're doing. I told you I've lived here 3 years and our taxes have gone up 3 times. And I just don't think it's right. So just look around and see who votes for it.
Question is Mr. Colmeyer. Mr. Colmeyer, did you not tell us out in the parking lot that we was not going to get our roads paved? Three of us were standing.
There might be a problem.
I didn't hear that part. I heard you say we're going to this road will not get paved. That was what we heard.
About money. You know what happened about money.
Next week.
It's always what you tell us, buddy.
You do.
Yeah. Everyone.
Thank you for your time. I spoke last week, and one of the gentlemen said, I bet nobody knows what their property taxes are. Well, I do, and they've gone up. And I just had my house appraised, and my taxes are $80,000 more than my house is appraised for. Now, that value doesn't compute to me. And I did go to this commission, these people you're supposed to see if your prices are too high. No, they said they were fine. I got this cement porch, and I got this, and now, what can we say? Okay, that's my one concern. I think that a lot of people's property around here is highly inflated, period. Number two, last thing I said to you before was that we were the worst city in the state of Tennessee to live in. I brought it for you. I'll leave it here. You folks are welcome to read it. It's from Road Snacks. This is what they say about the city of La Follette. First of all, the median income of the household here is very low. A family of four makes $20,336. It's just not enough to get by on. In fact, 33% of the population of La Follette is below poverty line. The unemployment rate is 8%, which is not the worst in Tennessee, but certainly up there. Home values are at $81,000. It's the seventh lowest in the state. La Follette is tucked away in the hills off I-75 on your way to Kentucky. Can you imagine the boredom level there is at the max? Would you believe that the crime rate way out there is the third highest in the state? If you're looking per capita, it's true. Every year, you have one chance in 12 of being robbed when you're within the city limits. And add it all up, and it truly is the worst place you could possibly live in Tennessee. And I find this offensive. I moved here because my family came from here in 1750. We have been here all these years. I love this place. I grew up in Michigan. I got my degrees in Michigan. I came back here every year with my family because nothing changed. Life was peaceful. People loved each other. They respected each other. And we do. I've got fantastic neighbors. You know, when a funeral goes by, people stop. They show respect. I don't understand why you would try, and I understand there's money needs, but I don't understand why you would take such a precious place when we're on very fixed, low incomes, and to try to take more from us. We're all struggling to make ends meet. Thank you.
Thank you.
Diana Hayter.
Diane.
Mr. Mayor, my name is Don Messer, and I'm going to repeat pretty much what I did last time. And we have in our midst opportunities for industry. We want tax increase. We get tax increase by employment in our local people here in Campbell County. You don't take them outside of Campbell County and reap the benefits of the taxes that they're paying in Knoxville, Oak Ridge, wherever. You have people, you have an industrial planning development board. What are they doing, number one? Number two, why not enlist some of these CEOs, presidents of companies, presidents of large corporations, manufacturing facilities, and get them on a volunteer basis? You know, I've been in industry all my life, my own businesses. So consequently, you have people already here in this county that would help you plan and develop a good plan to bring in industry. And if you don't take advantage of those and raise taxes, well, it's going to be a lose-lose situation for the county. We can't continue to raise taxes and survive on the taxpayers that people are living on welfare, they're living on SSI. What's the industry going to do? Tax them? And they won't pay property tax because they don't own anything. So take my advice. Get together with your councilman. These guys here, every one of them should be going out to industry. They should be over in Nashville talking to some of your representatives. They should be going and sending out brochures. And let the county, what did we have to offer industry? Do we have power? Do we have roads? Do we have industrial parks? What do we have that will attract industry other than the tourist industry? Can't live on that forever. You got homes out here that are going up left and right for sale, and they're not selling. You know why? People are tired, and they're getting older, and they can't afford these inflated prices on the lakefront homes. I know I have one, and I know perfectly well what the home value should be, but they're inflated up so high that people don't want to come and buy them. So you have a very limited amount of people. So take my advice. You guys get active and developing industry, and we'll get rid of we'll get the industry in here, and the tax rate will go down. But don't increase our taxes.
I have a question, Commissioner Nance.
Mr. Messer, I think you're a very intelligent.
Sometimes.
Would you be willing to volunteer?
I would, and I've had several other people talk to me about that as well. So.
Well, write your name down.
Okay, I appreciate it.